When you start having feelings of anxiety and panic, it's so confusing and you don't understand what is actually happening to you.
I didn't want anybody to talk to me or even look at me. I just wanted to just glide through and not deal with it.
I had to stay in there at break and lunch, so I feel trapped and I don't like to feel like I can't leave.
I'm Fiona, I'm 17 and I'm from Falkirk.
Hey, I'm Louise, I'm 19 and I'm from Falkirk.
I'm Megan, I'm 16 and I'm from Falkirk.
Basically, we want to stop people from having to leave school completely because of anxiety, because that's the one thing we all have in common, is that we all had to leave.
We want to help people suffering and also trying to support people with anxiety, better understand the illness.
Because I've always been like a worrier, but I've never known that it was anxiety the whole time.
I didn't see it at all. I just kind of tried to, I couldn't find the balance between time for myself, time to actually calm down and relax.
I was controlling something that I didn't even know I was controlling. School was the fear. And if you keep the fear under control like I thought it was, then that's fine.
I kept saying like, oh, I'll just try again the next day. I'll go the next day, and then the next day would come and I would just say, oh, I'll try again the next day, and then it just spiralled into never going again.
And the way I coped with it was by avoiding anything I thought would make me panic. If I feel like I'm trapped, it makes me panic. So I'd said to them, I feel like I'm trapped in school because the doors are locked and I can't leave and the classroom's quiet and you don't want to ask.
Whatever they were offering was meaningless to what was going on inside of my head, because I don't understand this, I don't know what's happening. I doubt that anything that they can offer is going to fix this, because it's not just going to school and learning, because classes are fine and I passed all of my exams.
I think they were frustrated with, because they didn't know how to help. They didn't know anything about anxiety. I don't think they even knew it was anxiety.
Oh, like you're not going to fit into the system? You're not going to go along with everyone else? Oh, we're not happy about that. I just felt really uncared for. I felt really, really unsupported by the school. And I felt like they just didn't get it. And I was explaining it. I was literally killing myself trying to explain what was wrong. And they just, it went straight over their heads. The reason my mind got so complex was because I didn't understand what was going on with me, and all I fixated on was the feelings that I got and how I didn't want to feel them, and I would do anything to avoid feeling it. I would be really aggressive with people if it meant I didn't have to go.
I'd say about a month and a half of dealing with it by myself before it was my mum that found out first. But I didn't willingly tell her, didn't want help, didn't want anyone kind of like interfering.
My anxiety was more sort of spiralled into somebody talking to me, like somebody speaking to me or recognising me is my worst nightmare.
Instantly I was, no, I'm not doing that. And it was like a couple of months because I said I'd think about it just to keep everyone happy and to leave me alone.
That's all I thought was, I'm going to leave the house, I'm not doing it, nope.
I left at 6 months and then, yeah, Carol came and met me in my house, which I burst into tears after like 2 minutes because I was that scared.
And when actually someone from the phoned me and explained how easy it was, how it was you were in complete control of what you were choosing to do, and that you would have a support worker, so you'd be supported the whole time, and things were totally, and the ball was always in your court, always. And that's when I realised, you know, I might try it.
Because I ignored their calls, as I do, because I just ignore people's calls. And she came to the house, and it was amazing to hear that. And the results from just meeting Carol and working with her have been amazing.
She has been the best thing that has ever happened to me regarding my anxiety, because see, if you have people shut you down constantly and constantly try and undermine your emotions and undermine what's wrong with you, they're constantly telling you, you know, this is your age, it's your hormones, you're, you know, yeah, that's fine that you feel like that, but, you know, you need to do this. and all she ever did was validate how I feel and just say that's fine.
The thing I think if you're at the beginning, it is always kind of the scariest part because you don't know what's happening, you just think you're going completely mental, is find the courage within yourself and not wait it out because you think you can control it yourself to open up.
But I think that understanding that not everybody around you is going to understand what's wrong with you, but that's fine because all that matters is that you understand and you protect yourself from other people's opinions. And basically I would say that it's really hard to talk to someone about it, especially even if it's just your mum or dad or someone that you already trust, to say, to be completely vulnerable and open with someone about, you know, something that's probably the hardest thing that you've ever been through.